name is Monica Kelly, and I'm a physical therapist at Glamaya Chiropractic Clinic. Would like to talk about sugar. Now, an average adult person have to intake about 2,000 calories a day. That would be about 100 grams of sugar. Now, 100 grams is like 6 tablespoons of sugar. Sounds loads, yes? Per day, 6 tablespoons of sugar. Think about something. You wake up in the morning, you have a half a cereal, you know, half a bowl of granola cereal. It's already your 4 tablespoons of sugar. You might add some fruit yogurt, it's another 4 tablespoons of sugar. So we live in a house overdosing the portion we're supposed to have per day. Now, biggest change at this day is that a lot of foods who are not supposed to have a sugar, they do, something like bread. Why is it bad? It's not only tastes very good, it tastes better, helps to sell more products, it's actually addictive. Even just thinking about the sugar and our brain and every way makes some kind of euphoric reaction. And at that chemical reaction in the brain, we produce dopamine. Now, dopamine is the one responsible for pleasure levels. So it does really not only helps to think that sugar is so pleasure feeling while you're eating, it makes it to want it later. Why is bad? Now, consuming sugar makes your body store fat. Our liver is responsible for all the work. You know, we need our insulin levels to be at healthy levels. But when we overload ourselves with the sugar, it's just too much for the liver to be able to take in and take out what we don't need it. So what starts happening is backs up. So she starts to kick out as much as we don't need it after we take everything what we do. That's all. That's our first step for going overweight. And it's not only obesity, it's thinking about high blood pressure, it's thinking about cancer, thinking about all kind of heart disease. Now, what good news is up today is the 5 small things you can change for a way better. No matter that you've already been consuming sugar for a while, it's very, very possible to actually go steps backwards to improve, okay? So first would be, change your added sugar drinks to something very basic, like water, like a sparkling water, yes? Second one would be, read the labels. So skip on something that's, fast, and just concentrate an amount of sugar in the product. If it's any added sugar in there, if it's any natural sugar that is already in the ingredient, yes? Third one would be exercise. Not much, 30 minutes a day already could keep your sugar levels and very, very good. Like I say, a perfect healthy line, yes? Fourth one would be absolutely no for fat-free foods. We all know that to remove fat in that process, they're gonna have to add sugar and added salt. Sounds way worse than having some fat, is it? We can actually talk about it in our next video. Now, a number 5 is consume more fiber, high fiber foods. And I'm not talking about reproduced white bread. I'm talking about something like brown rice, something all around, dark, high fiber bread. I'm talking about fruits, talking about vegetables, talking about nuts, that they actually helps you to not only keep you fuller for a longer amount of time, gives your energy levels higher. So when you do your exercise for 30 minutes a day, you don't feel tired after. You feel like you actually got extra power, extra energy, than actually lower after the exercise. So let's take those 5 steps and make a change now. Why not?